This tutorial is going to show you how to use browser users, and this can be really helpful if you are someone who does freelance or works with various clients, or if you just need to keep your work systems separate from your personal systems. So for example, I have a user for my own business and brand, and as I've showed you in my other tutorials, when I start that browser up, it opens up the basic services I need to start my day, and we've kind of gone over what those are and how I use them. Another aspect of my work is doing client work. I used to work with as many as 8 clients at once. Currently, I work with 2 clients on a monthly basis. And so it used to be like I would click here and I would have myself plus at least 8 different clients. I've scaled back on that a lot, but I don't know how I would have survived it without browser users. And so I'm going to show you what this looks like quick. So if I click on this client, it's going to open up a whole new browser window. And I can actually have these both minimized. So you can see down here, there's one that has my little icon on it and one that has my client icon on it. And so I can easily toggle back and forth between them or have them both up at once. They're both logged into all of the services that I need for that client. So for example, this client uses Outlook for email, Outlook for calendar. They also use Salesforce for client relationship management. So different services with different logins. However, by setting up a user profile, it opens up the browser, automatically opens up those services that I need, and gets me logged in so I'm ready to go. If you find yourself in a similar situation, either with your work or your personal life, where having these user profiles set up would be helpful for you, I want to just show you really quickly how simple it is. I'm going to be showing you this in Google Chrome, just like with my other tutorials. This is just my preferred browser and it's one that I recommend. However, most browsers support users, but last time I checked, Safari either doesn't offer it or just has really bad support for it. So I can't completely speak to that one, but I know that Mozilla, Edge, Internet Explorer, all of those have support for users. And the process is going to be pretty identical on all of them. But what you're going to do to get started is just click on your profile picture up in the top right where your profiles show up. You're going to go down to add and click it. And what should come up is a little pop-up like this. And on this page, you could either opt to set one up using a new Google account, or you could continue without an account. I'm just going to click continue without an account. On this page, you can give it a name and assign it a color or upload a profile picture. So I'll just go like that, and I'm also going to uncheck this create a desktop shortcut because I don't personally find that helpful, and I'll hit done. So now that profile user is created, and you'll see that if I go back to my main account, it's going to show up here as well. So now that's one I can easily switch back and forth between. And at this point, what I would do is go through those other steps that we talked about in lesson 6. Setting up your browser bar, creating browser folders, and identifying those designated startup tabs. I would make sure I was logged into all my services. I would get that stuff saved. So now every time I go and I open up that user, it would then open up a full suite of the services that I need. So hopefully that makes sense. Again, it can just be really helpful to help keep things separate and organized, but also to make it really efficient for you to switch back and forth between them. If you have questions about this, let me know.